Hey guys, it's Tom with SouthernFishNC. Just gonna let you know real quick. The last video I put up trying to do this video, the color correction, I took the last one down. I'm putting this new one up here because the sound was just terrible on the last video. You couldn't hear me. It wasn't right. I didn't like it, so I'm redoing it. And because I don't want to put out bad videos that y'all don't like. It ain't going to do y'all any good for me to put out videos that you can't hear, you don't understand, if, you know. So I'm redoing it just totally. And hopefully this will be a lot better. You can get more out of it where you can actually hear me. So anyway, guys, so get right down to it. All right, guys, so I'm in here in my video that I want to color correct, because that's what we're doing today. We're going to do a color correction video with my son. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to get on one of these clips down here, and I'm going to show you how easy it is and take full advantage of making your videos look the best they can be. This is jumping off rock right here. This is a beautiful place down here in Pisgah, on the other side of Pisgah, down towards Uari. So what I'm going to do is I've got this clip highlighted. So I'm going to come up here on the top of the timeline, right above it, where the cursor is, and click that to hold it still. So, and I'm going to turn this volume down. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go up here and click View, because I'm going to go into the color correction. I'm going to hit Show Video Scopes. And if you notice, this right here looks like smoke. Well, that ain't going to do you much good. What you want to do is click on this little gear wheel right here beside my cursor here, and hit the drop down and click on histogram. Alright, now you want to go down here to the little wand right here, the enhancements menu, and click on show color board. Alright, from this point, you want to go over here to where it says exposure. Alright, now, what you want to do is, you want to take this and drag it down toward a little bit closer to zero. What that's going to do is it's going to make the blacks blacker, the shadows, the way they're supposed to be. It'll make this picture look like a new picture. It just really change it up where it really looks good. So now I'll show you how to do this. It's very simple, very easy. I'll show you how to make this one clip and copy it to the other clips, and so that way, you know, you ain't got to do each one of these clips individually. So it's very simple. So we're going to get started here. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to put that about middle ways of this clip here, and I'm going to take and I'm going to drag this one right here down, this main one right here down a little bit. I'm gonna get it down, not too dark, but just about right there, because you want to keep this main body between 0 and 100. So then I want to come back up here and drag this highlight back up just a little bit, because I want it's going to take it quite a bit there. I want to take and bring this back to down where it's a little bit closer back to 100. You want to keep this whole thing stretched out between 0 and 100. Okay, then I want to come right here to my midtones, and just, because if you go up, it makes it darker, and it just, you see how that thing's going up and down, the little graph there. So I'm going to drag it down right below center line, about right there, okay. And now this shadows, drag it down just a hair, and that's pretty good right there. So we're going to scan over this right here. Okay, we'll get right here, and I'll show you how much better this is going to look. So I go up here and hit the arrow back button. So I'm here in effects, and I'm going to take and I'm going to drag this right here over just a little bit so you can see more. And if you click on that, you see how washed out it looks. See how much better that looks? That looks a whole lot better. You can actually see the little flowers and stuff coming up right here in the rocks. So now what I want to do is I want to take and I want to make all these other pictures or all these other video clips the same as this one. Very simple, very easy to do. So what I want to do is stay on this clip, and I use the shortcut, Command C. You can do the exact same thing. That's going to copy that. Everything about that clip is going to copy it. But you can also go up here and hit Edit, Copy, which right there is Command C. So I just like using shortcuts a little quicker. So once I've done that, I can take and I can pick whatever clips I want. All right, so I'm going to start right here. And I'm going to go right here and I'm just going to start highlighting all these clips down to right here. Okay, and this is just a video I'm working on from a trip, fall trip we made a few weeks ago. So I'm going to go up here and hit Edit, hit Paste Attributes, Color Correction. And click that box there and click Paste. So now all these clips look the same. And you can see, if I go up here and click Effects, see how much better that looks? Looks a ton better. Since I've gotten ScreenFlow, I can do a lot of different things with that. I can do little tutorials, and you guys who has the Final Cut Pro, little videos like this help me whenever I was getting into this type of thing, trying to learn Final Cut. These little videos helped me, plus my good friend Steve Sharon of Adventure Outdoors, he helped me out a whole lot, and still helping me as far as that goes. So guys, just remember to subscribe to my channel for more videos, and also fishing. You know, I'm be doing a Lucky Tackle Box unboxing here soon. I'll be doing a Lucky Tackle Box Slam with the baits that come in that box, hopefully in the very near future. If you guys like the video, please subscribe to my channel, share the video, and guys, until next time, y'all take care.